Hey friends, Pastor Bill Walden here. Hope you're doing great. This is a devotional for February 3rd, 2024, and this is out of Matthew 22. In the last parts of the Gospel of Matthew, we see Jesus in Jerusalem. We see him there during the Passover week before his passion, before his agony, before his torture, before his crucifixion, and of course, before his resurrection. But he's on the Temple Mount and he's teaching the people. The common people come to him gladly. The religious leaders of Israel were opposed to Jesus. He was, as they say, rocking the apple cart. He was showing their hypocrisy. He was interpreting to them the true meaning of God's word and the heart of God. There were two groups then, the Sadducees, who were very liberal and not spiritually minded. They were more naturalists. They didn't believe in the afterlife. They didn't believe in angelic beings. They didn't believe in miracles. The Pharisees believed in all of those things, but they were super self-righteous and put burdens on the people. And both groups were trying to trip up Jesus in his words. They were trying to present scenarios that would make him look foolish in front of the common man so that the public would start to doubt Jesus and his claims and the person of who he was. So the Sadducees, we read in Matthew 22, let me read it to you, then I'll make a couple of comments. Matthew 22, verse 23, the same day the Sadducees, who say there is no resurrection, came to him and asked him, saying, "Teacher, Moses said that if a man dies having no children, his brother shall marry his wife and raise up offspring for his brother. Now there were with us seven brothers," and this is all hypothetical, this isn't a true story. They're making up something to try to trap Jesus, and they're also creating a hypothetical story that they don't believe could ever actually happen. They're going to talk about the fact that in the book of Leviticus, if a woman became a widow and she had no children, the brother would impregnate her for the sake of raising up children in the name of his dead brother to carry on the family name and to keep ownership of the land and to continue the lineage of that family line. They said, "The first brother died after he had married, and having no offspring, left his wife to his brother. Likewise, the second also, and the third even to the seventh." So they're creating a ridiculous scenario. "Last of all, the woman died also. Therefore, in the resurrection, whose wife of the seven will she be? For they all had her." Now keep in mind, they are presenting to Jesus something that they really don't believe. They're just using the Bible to gain an advantage over Jesus and to try to trip him up. Jesus answered and said to them, boy, this is really, as we would say, a gut punch. "You are mistaken, not knowing the scriptures nor the power of God." These Sadducees only believed in the first five books of the Bible. They didn't believe in the prophets or the Psalms or any other book. They didn't believe in spiritual things. And yet they're saying in the resurrection, what's going to happen? And they're trying to discredit him. They don't even believe in the resurrection. Jesus said, "You are mistaken. You don't know the scriptures nor the power of God. In the resurrection, they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but are like angels." So it's not going to be even an applicable situation that you are addressing. "They are like the angels of God in heaven. Concerning the resurrection of the dead, have you not read what was spoken to you by God, saying, 'I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob.' God is not the God of the dead, but of the living." Jesus is here addressing some things that they didn't ask him about. They didn't believe in the afterlife, and yet Jesus is saying there is an afterlife. And he said, God said about himself, God is not the God of the dead, but of the living. It's not that he was the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It's that he is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He's the God of the living. The angels exist in heaven, and you don't believe in them. And you are mistaken concerning the scriptures. He said to them, "You are mistaken, not knowing the scriptures nor the power of God." Let me just make this one brief point. When we read the Bible, there's two ways we can read it, and there's two theological words. One is exegesis and one is eisegesis. One eisegesis is what I put into the story. It's what I read in. It's what I insert into the Bible. Exegesis is what exits the Bible and comes to me. It's what the Bible speaks to me. Exegesis is how we want to read the Bible. Eisegesis is not the way we want to read the Bible. And if we read the Bible with an eye of eisegesis, then we are saying, I think this is true. I'm going to force it into the Bible. I'm going to force it into the narrative. And as we do that, we will end up asking foolish questions that have no place to even be discussed about because they're not real. They're just imagined. And Jesus said to them, you are mistaken, not knowing the scriptures nor the power of God. May I encourage you, when you read the Bible, if you're a Christ follower or not, maybe you're a skeptic, maybe you would call yourself an atheist, maybe you would call yourself an agnostic, maybe you're blending Jesus with some Eastern thought or some other philosophy. Don't pick and choose what you take out of the Bible. Let the Bible speak for itself. Don't read into the Bible. Let the Bible read into you. So thanks for watching. God bless you. Bye-bye.